welcome to another episode of my channel. So today is a special day because today is Father's Day, and I thought of doing something different for Father's Day. So today I've invited someone very special in my life to just like have a chit-chat session. So it's going to be like very casual chit-chat session. And let me introduce you, my father.
Hello.
Mr. Michael Jacob. Okay. Hello. So I'm now right now spending time with my family at home. So I just want to take this opportunity to have a chit chat with my father, and you guys also can also get to know my father and you know a lot of things. Okay, so let's start, Acha.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, start.
So let me ask a question. Let's see if my father can remember where. When was I born, Acha?
Oh.
Let's see,
one.
Can tell everything exactly about.
Oh, she was born in hospital Taipei. The date of birth is 28 March 1990.
Okay. So you guys like basically can guess my age already. Okay. Yeah. When is my brother's birthday and where was he born?
Okay. I got only two charts, so easy to remember. La. So my son was on the 12th of July 1995 in Kuantan?
Hospital. Okay. Matthews, if correct, just give this a thumbs up and comment correct. Okay. So, okay, that is like basic question. Now, let's ask something about me if my father still remember. Okay. So, when like I was young time or like growing up time, like maybe in the school or what, anything you remember, like I was being very naughty or like, you know, small time when I was young, but try to think of something not too extreme. Something
to say naughty, no lah, because you go to school like, you know, you go very neatly and come back very neatly. So you actually all rounder, I can say you are very good girl lah. But once there was a incident when we were going for pasar malam. So then you were quite stubborn that you want something. Then we said no, then you started crying, and then you was adamant that you say I want the thing, and you know you're sitting
on the
so we just give a small
actually what I wanted at that, what I wanted.
You want some kind of
toys.
Oh,
okay. Actually I don't remember at all.
She don't remember.
I don't like can't recall, but I remember even my mom got tell that I was literally sitting in the road, right? I was literally sitting and saying
After that, she was not doing that anymore. Once today, you know, they just spank her just a little bit, then after that she...
But one thing about my father and mother is like, if I go and touch something once, they will just like look at me, or they were like, hey, that's all. Then the second time, my brother, we won't go and touch anything.
It's like her mother likes to, you know, decorate all kind of flowers. She'll put everywhere. So the mother also taught them. When they go and try to touch the flower, I know they won't touch. So we got no problem handling. So both of them, they are very good children.
Yes. Please. So fighting for them, we can give a thumbs up for this video. Okay. What else? Okay. So now we like saw ask a question about naughty side. Okay. Let's look at positive side. Okay. What like is the most proudest thing I've made you so happy?
Okay, I think there's a lot of things. One, I can say that you are always, you have an ambitious thing, like to go forward. You always, you know, to look forward better. So, one thing I was proud that you got your SRP, straight A's.
SPM,
straight A's. And then your SRP also what?
PMR.
That's the thing. First, her achievement.
Then both times also you cried, right?
Because it was a joy for me, because you know our children are achieving. No doubt it's an early age of their life, but it's a proud thing for as a parents lah. Okay, because the hard work, especially lah, my wife put in for in their life. Okay, it was a good thing to be joyful. It's actually the cry of joy lah. It's a laughter, celebrating it.
Actually, to be very honest, like even my PMR, I got 7 A's. I would say like 80% effort came from my mom because of waking me up every morning, like 5:30 or 4:30. I'll be like sleeping, like literally like so sleepy to do the sejarah paper. she will be like, Varo, finish in 1 hour, then we can go to sleep again. Then my dad, when SPM, when came to SPM, the only thing that I feel like literally changed my belief system was like he asked me to have the faith. Because every time SPM, because even my trial time, I was getting like what, 5A or 6A's only. I was not in one of the Plaza
Cemerlang.
So my father will be like, no lah, you straight A student, you are 11A student, definitely. Like when he says that, like you will start to believe it. You are like, yes, I think I am like that. So actually, I want to ask you about this also. Like that time you were telling all this, right? And then even when I was young time, I remember, I'll say, I want to go to Harvard University. You will be like, you sure? We'll go. Don't worry about that. You will get. Then even sometimes my mom will ask, how about the finance? How to finance the Harvard? But my dad will say, maybe she'll get scholarship. Like that thing were like so normal for you to talk about faith. So how this faith thing was like into you? Like how you got the knowledge?
I think it's basically because our belief, our belief in God, because our God is all possible. Nothing is too hard for him. So we also must have the attitude of God-like faith, you know. Mm. So God says something, he comes to pass. So I always have this love when we say something, and because faith is always, we look for things that is not seen. Faith, that is faith, we hope. So that is kind of faith because we believe for something. So when we say out, then it comes to pass. That's what I believe. This is a thing that you know God put in our heart. To look up to him. We never receive, but we have faith to pray and believe to receive. So that's how we apply to our children. You just believe, you can go, you can make it. Because when you say something, it's very powerful. Because the Bible says a lot of things. The life and death is in your tongue. When you say something, it happens. Why? Because you say it. So when you say it, it's powerful. That's what I believe. So always, I can see my wife always will push. That is another part of it. That is very good. Because without pushing also, she cannot move. So another part is, another thing is, my lifestyle is a simple faith. Just believe and can happen. So these two combination, we need a combination of this. We cannot say, just because of the father say something and happen. No. There is an input from both sides, myself and my wife. And that pushed her, you know. She was on one side, she was putting an effort. Another side, she was believing my word, you know, the positive words, the come forth words all. So I think that's how God do things, without faith, without work, there's your faith also cannot work.
So I think a lot of it, like because my father preached a lot in church and gives Bible study, even like every week we will have Bible study. And so whatever notes that my father give every week, like that thing also I like. Oh, that means in Bible it said like this, ask and you shall receive. So this kind of thing, like from young we all learn. So like literally it was easy for me also to have the faith.
You see, one thing I just a joke lah. Actually what happened, I always will tell her, you see, she will ask why your hair got so much of a hair, you know. So I'll just simply not claim.
I can zoom and show.
I said, oh, only genius will have this. So when she's young time, she believes that, oh, genius only have this. So when we put in positive things, you know, even though it's a lie, I'm just joking with her, but she absorbs it, I see there's truth, you know. So same thing, you put something that is for her future, you will go through this, you will achieve this. So it actually will come to pass, because you must take it like a child-like faith, you know, you receive it. Then you will, I can see God will do the wonders.
Because even like sometimes if I see anyone got a hair in their ears, I will tell my father, that means they are genius also, like you. But then I didn't know it was not true. Okay, so I think last question, then we end. Because a lot of great things my father like has done for the family, together journey with my mom. Like I would say I'm very blessed to be in this family, to mourn this family, because number one, the faith that they poured into me and my brother, and then second, the love can always be seen. Like literally, we born with love, and then third, like there's always peace in this house. So I think definitely it must come from Acha and from my mom. But what Acha, you think is your foundation for all this success? Like you're already married with Amma for 35 years. And I'm like literally also, you end my 30s already. So what is your foundation.
We both of us, every successful woman, there's a woman behind it. It's true. So, even to achieve that, so not only one side, not only my, I need my wife's help. Because most of the time I'll be working, I go morning 7 o'clock, come back evening 7 o'clock. And most of the things she'll be doing, even going to visit, going to school or anything, so she will go and handle for me. So, actually, it's through the cooperation or the unity of my wife. So that's how we share our love to our family, our children, so that we can be a successful family. If we cannot do single-handedly, cannot do by one person, it must be your partner, that is my loving wife.
Shall we introduce Amma also?
Oh, sure. We
can so let me invite my mom also and bring her into this. Okay. Hi, Amma. Hi. This is my mom. Her name is Victoria. I call her Victoria, but this is Mrs. Michael. Okay. So, Amma, anything you want to tell or give like a speech for Father's Day? You know, today, like we all are all celebrating around the world. All the fathers are, you know, they do hard work, they sacrifice for the family. So, one thing maybe you want to tell about your father, and then we can just like wrap up the whole thing.
Actually, it's really a blessed thing to be a father, I think.
Yes.
Because without a father, a home will not be fulfilled. They are doing so much of responsibility that we, you know, actually we cannot think of. So I'm very thankful also at this moment for my father who has done his job, his good job while he was on this earth. We really missed him as a family. Even my sister, yesterday I saw her WhatsApp profile picture. It was my dad and she missed him also. So me too. Actually really grateful that they were in our life. And now my husband, as he is a father, I'm also very happy that he is really a blessed man to this family. Indeed, I used to thank the Lord that he is actually a very good man. And he's also a very responsible father, as my daughter is now.
Yeah, because when I was growing up, every time my mom will tell, you are very blessed, Varo, to get a father like him.
Yes.
So, that,
so we were, I really grateful to God that he is really a good man. And till now, my children really appreciate him for that. So I'm also very happy for that, to see my kids. You know, today, they making this video, I thank the Lord.
Just one thing I like to say, that anybody can become a father, okay? Becoming a father is not a problem, anybody can do it. But being a responsible father is the most important thing, okay? That is the most. Then only the family, the children and their future will be better. So that's one advice I can give, is being a responsible father, that is the most important thing. So that your children, family will be blessed and be good. God bless you.
Okay. Thank you so much, Acha Amma, for joining this. I think this is the first time I'm introducing my parents in YouTube, and I'm very blessed that I got this opportunity.
Yeah, we are also very blessed to have both of you in our life.
Thank you so much. Bye, guys. Bye. Bye. Okay, hi guys, hi everyone, this is Veronica here, and wait, I'll introduce you again, please start.